Hey guys, it's Ms. Cáceres again. So let's start by copying down our heading, name, grade, and section, and date. Obviously leave some space for your title for today. Objective, to research to find high schools that serve recent immigrants. And our I can statement is, I can recognize the purpose of a documentary. Now remember, if you need more time to copy this, you can always pause, rewind, or come back later to my YouTube channel. So we watched the video. Now we are going to go through the reading or the informational text that was written by Brooke Hauser. Here's a little background information on Brooke Hauser. She is a longtime journalist, profiled a wide array of subjects from Chinese beauty queens to former U.S. Secretary of State Colin Powell. However, in her first book, The New Kids, Big Dreams and Brave Journeys at a High School for Immigrant Teens, she chronicled the experiences of people who don't normally take center stage. Recent immigrants who attend the International High School at Prospect Heights. The following text is informed by what she learned and whom she got to know while writing the award-winning book. So we come to part one, which is entitled A Second Home, first paragraph, and now we have analyzed the text elements, which we talked about in the video before. You will annotate in your textbook by highlighting the first subheading in the article. Once you've done that, it's time to predict. Based on this subheading, what can you predict about the overall structure of the article? Type in your answer. And remember, when we're done answering all of the questions, guys, you got to hit this little check button here for me so you can hand in your work. Now we move on to paragraph 2 and 3, which you can see our critical vocabulary is included. If you need a quick reminder of what this word means, you click on it and a new window will open up with examples for you. Now, coming past paragraph 6 and 7, you'll come to a question which has the entitle of quoted words. Our notice and note, highlight the quoted words in paragraph 7. Remember that quoted words are words that are found between quotations. Now, we evaluate. The author could have paraphrased what the principal said or restated the ideas in her own words. What is the effect of including the principal's exact words? Type in your answer. And once you're done, come to paragraph 8. We come now to part 2 of the reading, A New Identity. Paragraph 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, all the way to 16, and you have another analyze the text elements. You're going to annotate in your textbook the phrase in paragraph 16 that has a footnote. Remember, we talked about these text elements. Once you've done that, you come back to the online platform and you type in your answer to the infer question. What does the footnote help you understand about the International High School at Prospect Heights? Also remember to use capitalization and punctuation is key. Here we have an element, which is a graph, or better known as a pie graph, with obviously statistics and facts at the bottom. We come to paragraph 17, and now we have a language conventions. Annotate in your textbook paragraph 17 by highlighting the use of the parenthesis. Once you've done that, come back to the online platform and type in your answer to the analyze question. Does the sentence make sense without the parenthetical information? Practically, they're asking you, would this still make sense if you didn't have this information? Why do you think the author decided to include it? Write down your thoughts on that. We come to paragraph 18, 19, and now we are in part 3, A Global Perspective, paragraph 20, all the way to paragraph 22, where we have yet another analyze the text elements. In your textbook, annotate in paragraph 22 the information that is also represented by the bar graph. Once you've done that, again, you come back to the online platform and answer the analyze question. What does showing this information graphically help the author to emphasize? Explain. Once you've done that, we go to paragraph 23 and we come to our big questions. Notice and note. One question you should ask yourself when reading nonfiction texts is, what challenged, changed, or confirmed what I already knew? Highlight any details in the bar graph that help you answer this question. Once you've done that, come back to the online platform and answer the summarized question. How does the information in the graph connect with what you already know or believe to be true about graduation rates? Here you go on the bar graph of the graduation rates. Little bit of statistical information. We come to paragraph 24 and 25. We have yet another language conventions. Annotating in your textbook in paragraph 25, the sentence that uses a semicolon. Once you've done that, we come back to the platform to answer the analyze question. Explain why a semicolon is needed in this sentence instead of a comma. You should remember what the usage of a semicolon is useful for. Paragraph 26, all the way to paragraph 30, and we come to the end of our story. Now remember, when you guys are done, always check your grammar, spelling, punctuation, capitalization, and click the check button to send in your completed assignment. Well, I'll catch you guys next time. Take care.